This video assumes you are using the 4-channel amp to power front and rear speakers already installed on an Ultra Classic. Before starting, please remove the seat and undo the two main wires on the battery. Remove the outer fairing and put aside. Put something over your front fender like a towel just in case something drops during the install. Gently take the wires off each front speaker. Undo each rear speaker grill, lift up on the speakers, remove each rear speaker wire, and put the rear speakers and grills aside. Since we are installing the amp on an Ultra Classic where we want the radio's fader to control volume between front and rear, the switch on the side of the amp needs to be set to the fader position. The mounting arms that suspend the amp and the fairing are installed by removing the four screws on each end of the amp, placing the arm over as shown, and reinstalling the screws. Locate the power harness and plug it into the matching pigtail on the side of the amp. Locate the input harness and plug it into the matching plug on the side of the amp. Locate the front out harness and plug it into the front out on the side of the amp. On the long rear harness, you will see two 4-pin plugs on one end. One of the two plugs will plug into the empty 4-pin plug on the input harness, and the other 4-pin plug will plug into the rear out on the side of the amp. Since this is an Ultra, there is a CB module mounted on top of the radio. Remove the screw that secures the CB module to the back of the radio and let the module hang for now. There are two bolts on each side of the radio that holds the radio in place. You will loosen the two closest to the front of the radio and remove the two closest to the back of the radio. The slots shown here will slide over the front bolts, and by reinstalling the two back bolts, the amp will be in position suspended slightly above the radio. Make sure all four bolts are retightened. Locate the module shelf and the supplied stove bolts and nuts and attach it to the mounting arm. The bolts must be oriented as shown here. With the shelf in place, slide your CB module in place and use the factory screw removed earlier to secure the CB module in place. If you cannot get the module in place, you can also use the Velcro that came in the kit to stick the module in place. With the amplifier in place, take the yellow-black wires on the input connector of the amplifier and plug them into the front factory speaker wires on the clutch side of the bike. They will only go in one way. Take the brown-black wires on the front out connector and plug them into the front clutch side speaker. They will only go in one way. Take the green-black wires on the input connector and plug them in the front factory speaker wires on the brake side of the bike. Take the blue-black wires on the front out plug and plug them into the brake side front speaker. Like the others, these will only go in one way. At your cigarette lighter, unplug the factory orange wire. Depending when your amp was made, you will take the yellow or orange wire on the power harness and plug its female connector directly to the bike's lighter. The factory female connector will plug into the male connector left over. The power and ground harness and rear harness will pass together under the inner fairing where the main wire harness passes through on the brake side of the bike. Although you can remove the gas tank to run wires if you choose, we like to loosen the tank's chrome console and run wires up and over the gas tank, but under the tank's chrome console. There is a provision on the front of the tank console for wires to pass. When correctly installed, the power and ground wires are the right length to connect to the battery, and the 8-pin plug on the rear harness is the right length to be zip-tied to the brake side fender strut. Be sure to run the rear harness under the airline for the brake side rear shock. At the very end of the rear harness, you will see two pairs of black shorter wires in a sheath and two pairs of black longer wires in a second sheath. The longer wires will get run behind your seat and into the opening on the clutch side where the factory speaker wires enter. Plug the factory rear speaker wires into the male wires of the amp harness. The factory plugs for the rear speakers are not insulated, so once plugged in, please wrap them in electrical tape as shown. The two female wires from the amp will be attached to the clutch side speaker. Repeat these steps for the opposite side rear speaker box. Attach the amp's red wire to the positive battery terminal and the amp's black wire to the negative battery terminal. The factory battery wires are also reinstalled at this point. When the final two connectors touch the battery, some minor sparking is normal. Turn the stereo on, and at low volume, test to make sure all speakers are working and the fader on the radio works. Reinstall the rear speaker grills and seat. This is the best time to clean up the wiring using the supplied zip ties. With the wiring secure, it is very important you turn your front wheel to each extreme side to make sure the wiring does not impede your steering, noting that failure to do so can cause serious injury. Once you're satisfied your steering is okay, go ahead and reinstall your fairing and your new system is ready to enjoy.